jump back 3 years to the start of all this. I ended my career as a failed YouTube superstar and moved into a house with four of the weirdest people on planet Earth. Lex, a man who likes to shout a lot. Phil, a man that barely talks and barely walks. JC is a dedicated father of three. Two of them are his actual children, and one of them is the tapeworm that lives inside of him. And then there's Milo, a successful businessman that I steal a lot of money from. After a short time with them, I had had enough, so I decided to leave and move back to England, which I quickly realised is horrible. So I decided to spend the next year of my life starting a business to make enough money to help me move. And unfortunately, I met a few more weirdos along the way. In fact, these guys may have been more weird than the last ones. And then at some point, Phil left the business to go pursue his dream of becoming a wrestler. I have no idea what happened there. You know, and all that ridiculous stuff kind of leads us to right here in Austin, Texas. And I'm sure after seeing all that, you're probably all pleased to hear that after 3 long years, this absolute tragedy is finally coming to an end. I'm going to leave you now. I'll speak to you again in a few episodes. If you make it. There, that is. I'll understand if you don't.
Why are you running?
You know, we spent 14 days of the year walking. So I thought, like, we've only got a month here. So I may as well run everywhere because I might get, like, 2 extra days. You know, I'll do a little bit more with my life.
You look like you're going to die, man.
I'm good. I could do with my inhaler, though. Seeing that anywhere.
Your what?
My inhaler to breathe because I got a little...
Here. We've been puffing on that shit all day, man. It's got some good shit in it.
Great. Well, you know, stop using my inhaler to get high, please, because... I got little bitch lungs now. I need it to live.
You're missing out, man. There's some good shit in there.
What's going on here? What are we doing?
We're eating spaghetti.
Why are you eating it directly off the couch?
So we don't have to clean your dishes.
But now the couch is filthy. Like,
listen, it's not a couch, okay?
But I have to sleep on the couch, and now it's covered in spaghetti. Why can't you just use plates?
Oh, it's okay. We can just throw a towel over it. It's fine.
Yeah.
Watch.
See?
It's fine.
You're taking very simple things and making them complex for absolutely no reason at all.
We're doing what makes life easier, okay? And that's just a part of the process.
But there's stuff that already exists to make this easier. You know, if you want to eat food, use a plate. And if you want to get high, you know, smoke crack like the rest of us. But stop using my inhaler and stop eating spaghetti off the couch. It's weird. It's weird.
It's not that weird, though.
You just signed the spaghetti, didn't you?
Yeah.
Well, that's pretty embarrassing for you. This whole situation's kind of embarrassing.
The thing is, Liam, we don't even need the dishes. The couch is right
here.
We sit on the couch to watch the TV. I don't understand.
Guys!
Milo, we're trying to have a very serious spaghetti debate right now. It's very important stuff going on here. So let's just, like, do this and you take your thing somewhere else because...
Yeah, Phil's dead.
This is, like...
Oh.
Oh, shit.
How did he die?
Some kind of wrestling accident or something.
Damn. Jeez. That's a shame, but I think we all saw that one coming, to be honest, because he should not have been in a wrestling ring, you know, but
yeah,
rest in peace, Phil, you know,
yeah,
God bless and all that sort of stuff. But let's get back to this spaghetti debate right here, because this is weird and I want to get to the bottom of it, because, like, just
wait,
eat off a plate,
no,
you know.
No, we're not doing it. No,
here.
Okay,
we're,
so
we're,
I was on the phone with this lawyer
happening,
and Phil left us something.
He left us something?
Yeah, us.
Oh, shit!
Mm-hmm.
Type of stuff we're talking about here.
He didn't actually say. It could be anything. It could be a hot tub for all I know.
A hot tub? I'm in. Let's get ourselves a hot tub.
It probably isn't a
hot
tub.
You said it was a hot tub. We're getting a hot
no.
tub.
Did you say hot tub?
No, it could have been.
We're getting a hot tub.
You said hot tub.
Hot tub?
As in, it,
you
as
say
in
hot tub?
One
hot
of
hot
the
tub?
Infinite
hot
things.
Hot tub?
It could have been a hot tub.
We're getting a hot tub.
No, it could have been any one.
Let's go
get any multitude of things.
We have the noodles for the swimming pool.
For goodness sake. It could be anything. It's not a hot tub. It isn't a fucking hot tub.
Today. I'm very sorry for your loss.
Right, well, thank you. You know, I think we're all over the lost part at this point. No, we're all just ready again now.
Man, what the fuck did he leave us with?
Are you going to let him do his job or, like, I'm really sorry. I don't know why he's acting this. Well, I mean, I kind of know why he's acting this way, but I apologize truly and sincerely. I'm sorry.
Okay, well, I have Phil's last will and testament here.
Does it say anything in there about a hot tub or anything like that?
No.
No? No, well, that's weird. You see, this weird creature sat next to me sort of promised that there would be a hot tub involved in this. He said that we'd be getting a hot tub, so...
I did not promise a hot tub.
Well, from a, well, you did. I think.
No,
I think
I
you
didn't
did.
I think promise I you a
saying,
hot tub.
I think I remember you saying, like, you know, you will definitely get a hot tub from this. Phil has definitely left us a hot tub. I think those were the words.
I heard it with my ears.
He heard it with his ears. So, you know, if you want to give us the hot tub and anything else that you want to share with us, I think we'd all be very satisfied with that, you know?
We also have a very heated spaghetti argument we'd like to get into.
Right. If you could solve that for us, that'd be great, because we're having a hard time with it. It's a weird situation. They're eating spaghetti off the couch. It's very strange.
I'm sorry.
Okay, I have no idea what you're talking about.
He's talking about the hot tub, man. What the hell?
I'm talking about the hot tub that you're going to give to us.
There is no hot tub. There is no hot tub, okay? There isn't one. It was just an example that I used. I could have said anything. It could have been a house.
A house?
Oh my god.
A house? I can go for a house. If you can give us a house, that would be great. I would be down to get a house, you know?
What if it has a hot tub?
We could put the hot tub in the house.
Hot tub in the house. I'm down for that.
Hot tub house!
We'll get the hot tub and the house,
HGH.
Please. We'll take that to go.
I like that. I think.
Well, actually, he did leave you something.
Push it left, push it left.
We're much better than this.
Really? We should put nitrous on these wheelchairs.
That's exactly what I was thinking. We should absolutely do that.
I was thinking that too.
Right. Now, if we modified this a little bit, we could pick up some serious speed going down this hill here, because this isn't really moving as fast as I expected it to, because it's not really what I pictured when they said wheelchair to us.
Well, Phil probably spent a lot of time in this chair when he was gaming, so it's probably pretty sentimental when you think about it.
Right. Yeah, I mean, I can sort of smell his anus radiating from the chair, you know?
Liam, stop, come on. Like, we're better than this. We've got to be better than this.
Yeah, we already agreed. We can be better than this. That's why we're going to put nitrous on the chair. That's...
No, but all you care about right now is nitrous-powered wheelchairs and hot tubs.
Well, what else are we supposed to care about?
We need to give him a funeral.
That doesn't sound very fun.
That sounds boring as shit.
Wait a second. You know, hold on, because I think this could actually be good for us.
How can a funeral be better than a rocket-powered wheelchair?
Well, think about it, right? Think of all the free shit we've already got. You know, we've already got a wheelchair out of this. Now think of what else we could get.
Hot tub.
Exactly. Now this wheelchair idea is too good of an idea to put on the back burner. Like, we all agree about that, right?
No.
JC and Lex, you're gonna go do that, and me and Milo are gonna do the funeral thing, and then we're gonna regroup here later on, and we're gonna watch JC blast down this hill at incredibly high speeds. It's gonna be incredibly dangerous, massively unsafe, and we're gonna make him do it because I don't really feel like risking my incredibly valuable life. You know, does that sound good?
Absolutely. Yeah.
I don't really want to get hurt.
All right. Yeah. Let's do it. Now, I was thinking that would give everyone the true Phil experience, and we put wheels on the bottom of all the chairs, and that way they can get immersed in his lifestyle for a little while.
No, Liam, we are not doing that. Come on. We're just going to do exactly what he asked for when he was with us when we were planning all our funerals.
Right, well, I don't think he was there for that.
Wait, what? Where was he then?
I think he was already wrestling by that point. He was long gone.
So we have no idea at all what he would have wanted?
I have no idea.
Great. Okay, well, let's at least start with the things that he liked, maybe? His interests, that sort of thing?
Right. There was wrestling. That was one of them.
I guess so. Mm-hmm. I guess that counts, but what else?
Being disabled.
Yeah, no. That was just who Phil was. That's not really an interest.
Right. Well, I mean...
So is there anything else?
No, I guess I didn't really know a lot about him, if I'm being honest. Like, his only personality traits were... You know, being disabled, his love for wrestling. He didn't really like JC very much.
I mean, nobody likes JC.
Right, yeah, I mean...
Thinking about it, though, it's weird. Like, maybe we should have made an effort to learn more about the guy. I feel like I hardly know anything about him.
Well, you know, maybe he should have made an effort to open up more to us.
Well, I don't know. We lived with the guy for a month, and I still feel like I hardly know him or knew him.
But, like, it's not really our fault that he's an incredibly two-dimensional person, you know? Like, we should really be blaming the person that made him that way.
I mean, the circumstances made him who he was, not just a person making him that way.
Right. But I'm saying at the end of the day, it's not our fault.
Okay, whatever, okay? It's fine. Let's make a list of his friends, and then we can invite them, because they'd want to be here, right?
Right, that's good. That's good. We're getting the ball rolling now. We're getting stuff moving. That's good. That's a good start.
Okay, so... Who are his friends?
Right. Us? We're his friends.
Yep, okay.
So right, us. Get us down on that list, because...
So that's us.
Yeah.
Who else?
Shit.
I'm in some real trouble with this, actually.
Yeah.
I mean, we were his friends. We should probably know who his other friends were.
Yeah. But are we his only friends?
Damn.
Maybe, but...
Shit.
Yeah.
Because I don't want to be here.
Yeah, neither do I.
Hey,
you got the stuff we need?
Yeah, it turns out that I have no idea how to build a rocket power wheelchair.
Yeah, I've been thinking about it. I don't know how we would make that happen, to be honest.
Exactly, dude. Liam Milo knew that we wouldn't be able to do it, and I think that's why they sent us out here, to get us out of the way.
You think so?
I know so. You know, look at all the cool shit that we missed out on. I think Liam and Milo don't value us as members of the business.
Hey, is there any food in that bag?
No, but I did buy this.
What's that?
It's a boombox.
Why'd you buy a boombox?
Because there's no way that we can go in the house with a rocket-powered wheelchair, so I bought this so that we can go all out to impress them.
Why don't you just play music on your phone?
You don't understand, man. It's about the theatrics. I'm gonna bump this on my shoulder, blasting some bangers, and you're gonna be on the wheelchair.
Honestly, it sounds like a boogie.
Dude, we're gonna get this shit hyped up, and we're gonna go in, and we're gonna take their tits and blow them right off, baby.
You know what today's made me realize? We know basically nothing about each other.
What are you talking about?
Well, like Phil, for example. I don't know anything about the guy.
Right, but he's not here anymore, so why does it matter?
Well, I mean, other than you, I know basically nothing about the people that are actually involved in our business.
Oh, so you know me?
Well, yeah, I can read you like a book.
Right, what's the book say?
It says you're a pathological liar, you have a terrible case of body dysmorphia.
Yeah. Is the book saying that I'm a beefcake or not?
No.
Right, well then your book's wrong.
I mean, okay, let's take JC for example. JC is impossible to read. He's so stupid 99% of the time. And then in that 1% of the time, he'll say something that's genuinely a decent idea. And it just makes me think there's like a tiny little man in his head trying to get out, like a smart guy in there that's just trying to break free, you know?
Right, well, I don't really see any of that, if I'm being honest. But this is the group dynamic that we have. It's good. Like, if we know any more about each other, it just kind of gets weird.
Why would it be weird?
Because everything on Earth has like a turning point where it's just not as good anymore. Like take JC's dad, for example, right? His life was probably going pretty well. And then he made JC, and it was just all kind of downhill from there for him.
Fair?
Right, so like, if we learn a bit more about each other, we'd start finding out all kinds of weird shit, and like, possibly illegal stuff as well. And that would just change the way that we look at each other. The whole dynamic would be off, and then it would all be downhill from there for us.
I mean, I guess, but you're not even a little bit curious about all the amazing things that you don't know about me? Like, there's a bunch of stuff you don't know about me.
Good. I want to keep it that way, because I don't give a shit, if I'm being honest.
Are you sure this is safe?
It's totally fine, man.
I feel like I should be wearing, like, protection or something.
Nah, you'll be fine.
Why are you standing so far away, then?
You know, I'm just trying to assess the situation. Stand at a, you know, take my distance.
I have kids. I don't think I should be doing this.
Listen, I think you're starting to lie to me about your kids, man.
I'm not lying. I have kids, Lex. They're really important to me. I love them.
Listen, we're best buds, right?
Yeah, of course.
If we're best buds, how have I not seen even one of your children?
I can show you a picture right now. I have it in my
pocket. Put it away.
Okay.
I don't give a shit. I'm more interested about the rocket-powered wheelchair than your damn ass kids, okay?
Okay, so what do I do? I just spray it and I move?
I have no clue, man. Let's try that out, though. Let's give it a go.
Okay, here it goes. Did it move?
A little bit.
Did it look cool?
Not at all.
Well, I mean, all we have to do is just get it to move a little bit and they'll be happy. We can go home.
Ah, JC, listen, we gotta do more. We gotta get it done faster. We have to sell it so we can impress them, man.
I mean, we already got the boom box. We're already doing a bunch of things to impress them. Let's just do a little dance as well.
Listen, you're not even listening to me, JC. We have to do it so that we can really impress them. We got to get this thing going on clock 8. Is that a speed? A Mach 8. I want this wheelchair to hit fucking Mach 10 on that rocket power.
How are we going to do that?
This is boring as shit.
Come on, we hardly knew anything about the guy. How are we gonna make an interesting funeral? Like, this is basic, it works.
Let me just do the wheels on the chair thing away, real quick. Like, it's just gonna be an interesting spin on the whole situation.
Let's just keep it simple. I don't want you doing anything crazy here, Liam.
Well, it's not that crazy, you know? Like, it's just... I'll do it, like, real quick, in and out, you know, just to make it a little bit more visually pleasing.
Liam, it happens every time. You always ruin things by taking them too far.
You're gonna ruin it by putting people to sleep during the ceremony, you know, so...
Do you know the story of Icarus, Liam?
What are you talking about?
Icarus was a little boy who had wings. He could fly, right? And one day, little kid Icarus decided he was gonna go way too far with things and flew into the sun. And now he's dead.
Right. Well, that's a great story and all, but... I don't really see how it pertains to this situation, because this doesn't say flying at all. Like, the kid could fly in the first place. That's very, very impressive. Like, if a kid, like, started flying, like, even an inch off the ground in front of me, that'd blow my tits off. That's amazing. But none of this says flying to me. This says I'm very firmly planted on the ground. I never intend to leave the ground. I never have left the ground, not even with, like, a tiny little jump. You know, I'm staying here forever. That's it.
Damn it! We made one of the best, most technological advancements the world has ever seen! It's the most powerful rocket-powered wheelchair!
What?
I completely forgot that this was happening, if I'm being honest.
You lads might want to step back, okay? Because this bitch can go at some turbo speeds. Honestly, I think y'all gotta move. Step back! Step back!
What is going on?
I don't think this is gonna work, dude.
Listen, I know it's not gonna work, but we gotta really damn sell it, okay?
Everybody,
I guess.
We're prepared for launch, okay? 3, 2, 1!
Ow.
So can I do my thing now, or?
Sure.
I want to thank you all for being here today, especially Chopper, who came in very quickly, very last minute. He didn't even know Phil, never met him once in his life, but sadly he is one of the only people that we actually know, which is a shocking fact that I found out today, but thank you. Anyway, I think we all learned something from Phil's life, and that's that we shouldn't do things that our bodies weren't made for. You know, a man built like Phil should never have been in a wrestling ring suplexing someone, because, you know, for that you need the use of your legs, which we all know that he did not have. Today I learned that Phil is a man of mystery that I barely knew. But what I did know is that he had a very sweet hot tub that any one of us would be lucky to own. So if any of you have any information that could lead us to that hot tub, you know, and get it in our possession, that would be nice. Or if you have a hot tub of your own that you want to kindly donate to us, that would be very much appreciated. But for now, we're going to pay tribute to Phil's life with a dance routine from Lex. Doesn't make you cry, I don't know what will.
Yeah, I mean, to be honest, I think you did a pretty good job with this move.
Yeah, I was hoping maybe a few more people might show up, because that whole hot tub bit was kind of intended for a larger crowd, but it's...
Well, at the same time, it's kind of more tasteful this way. Like, I'm actually pretty impressed. You didn't go as over the top as I thought you were going to.
Yeah, well, you know, maybe you don't know me as well as you thought you did. You know? Oh, shit, he's here.
Wait, who's there?
Well, I ordered a wrestler to come beat the shit out of JC and then Phil's honour.
What?
Yeah, he's the weird one over there, the gangly arms. Yeah, that's it. Oh!